like leg down.
I know.
They put they other leg up.
Some pelicans across the way. They just finished draining the It's something funny on his beak. I guess they all do. Just finished draining the pond. I think it's filling up now. You can see there's all these fish that is right at the top of the water. Looking for deeper spots, I guess.
Look at that little bit of water right there. What does that look like? It's a fish.
There's a big old turtle also that's trying to find deeper water. Big old snapping turtle. Oops. Slowly moving along.
My challenge type, his name is Spike, and he is a Nande conure. They come from South America, mainly Argentina in the grasslands. And he's a very intelligent bird. The trick that he does in the show is he lands on someone's arm, takes something out of their hand, and brings it back to me, and then he takes it back to them. So he's very, very smart. But hoops are difficult for him. You would think it would be easy for a bird to learn to fly through hoops. But you're asking him to go through something that's strangely colored, that surrounds them completely, and also is a bit of a challenge in that it's over an audience, and they aren't too sure about it. So first he had to learn that the hoop is not going to eat him. Then he had to learn to go through it to get some treats. So we're going to try to do that again. First of all, we'll try something new. Can you give away? There you go.
Is going to fly that box up there.
Over the audience. Don't be afraid that she's going to land on you. She just likes to fly over the audience and then land on me. But if a big red bird
come down, fly through the hoops, maybe. First time they've flown down on the stage for the hoops up. Today's like a learning session for everybody. And fly through that hoop over there.
Let's go ahead and give it a try,
Deborah. And they come. One's coming around again from behind us.
There you go. Nice job.
There we go. Pretty bird.
They decided not to fly over the audience because she's afraid of the hoops. See, but now she's learned that she doesn't have to be afraid of them. So she can now hopefully fly in the show and not have to worry about them. Now, one of the reasons why we train all these birds to do these things is to show you how smart they are, and also train these other animals too, like the opossum, to show you how they have to do things to survive in the wild. It's not easy out there in the wild. They aren't just flying around having a good time, but they have to look out for predators, they have to try to find food, and you have to be very intelligent to do that. And so these animals have to learn these things, and then they also do have instincts that help them survive.
We're down there looking at the birds and the possum. They're training the possum. This will be the second trained possum in the United States.
It's okay, I've got him. You don't have to. Do it.
Oh, there you guys are.
Nathan, don't. Hold on. There's the cheetah. There's two more back there.
One over there.
Come stand over here, Rachel. You can
sit. Another one. Yeah.
They're the boys.
Oh. They look like they're wobbling all over the place.
Nothing matters.
Look at the
Where'd it go?
To go in the way.
There they go.
Not drawing.
Taking a lot of stills.
That little hook of beans that he put in the garden, he's got such a good skin, and it just lets him know he's normal.
There!
Oh, yeah?
All right. There's Rachel and Mommy. Whoops.
The beautiful $1 million brand new barn.
Having a good time. Feeling the skin? Hold on, Nathan.
They're watching them.
Yay. Guess where they are. Taking a little nappy. Oh, we missed him. Nathan's poking his head up top somewhere. A big cave. There's Andrew up top.
Elizabeth! We did it!
Baxter, over here, son.
Look at the...
Whoa, you did it! You want to go through all the
way? Here's Rachel. Oh, she's gone. Rachel, where'd you go?
Andrew! Where are you going, hon?
He's looking for him.
She's inside the cave.
There's Rachel. There are the otters.
Nathan and Rachel traveling around.
Kenny's doing good. Andrew just got a haircut today. Hey, Nathan, let me see your mouth. Here, hold still so I can see where your mouth. We went to the zoo today. I guess not. And Nathan lost another tooth. Open.
Next to
don't pull back yet. Hold on, Rachel. There it is. There's the hole.
Next to my grown-up tooth.
I know it. I saw it.
Come back.
And the Easter bunnies are sitting out.
Oh, my gosh.
You almost hit your
chin. Hey, Kelly.
Get them. Sit down. Here. Come right here and sit down. Thank you. I'm afraid you're going to hurt yourself. There's a hospital right up here, but we don't need to use it.
These two are tired. The zoo today, and then swimming, and so they are acting up a little bit. There's Nathan. He has Easter egg eyes.
Did they give him a colored one?
It's a metal one.
In front of Granny's bunnies.
It's like a tubey set.
Stop by. Getting ready to get on the road. Head north again.
Nathan did that too.
I know.
What time is the
pigeon
for?
Is it?
Well,
I'm
so stupid.
Huh?
Who said that?
The pigeon's silly. They just had pancakes for lunch and they're all full of sugar and energy.
Sugar.
Rachel, get up in front of Granny.
I didn't have any sugar. I said you had pancakes.
Because I ate myself. I just ate myself.
Get up in front of Granny, Rachel.
I didn't eat mine.
Up in front of Granny.
Granny don't have a lot of padding back there to sit on the brick.
I didn't eat mine.
Nathan, Rachel, sit in front of Granny. Two, three. Good.
I'm a cheater.
Good smiles.
See, we can smile. Smiley face.
That's what you did.
There's the three.
When you get home and you, I don't know if you'll see your grandmother. They call her what?
Grandma?
Grandma. See if you see your grandma. She?
Yeah, she's going to come up.
Oh, how nice.
She might be there when we get there.
That'd be nice. She'll have your house all straightened up.
Maybe. She gets there early.
Yeah, sure she will. Your mama's a whiz. She never sit down. And then she found out about Chet. She walked the floor and she was all upset. And I felt bad, you know. And I said, if you need to go home, go ahead. No, but she, no,
he'll be all right.
Here we are back at Granny's house playing a little ball before we get on the road.
What do you mean?
Let's see you shoot, Andrew.
I got on.
All right. Let's go look. Birdie up in the nest there. See his eye? Nathan's pulling out some weeds out of the garden. He's got some pretty healthy spinach growing back there. We had an Easter egg hunt here the last couple days. We'd hide eggs and look for them all over, even in the wood pile and under the pots, all around the back of the house. Pool's covered up. It's been a while since it's been used. You can see through the black tarp. Paint's peeling off the side a little bit. Andrew's checking out the bird. Don't break it, Nathan. Well, it's warm. It was in the 80s last couple days, and it's in the lower 80s today, is upper 80s before. Here's the view out our windows, and you can definitely see why they call it the Great Smoky Mountains. It's starting to clear up a little bit now, but there's definitely that smoke hanging around. It's a pretty nice view. Just burned off the top of that one. It's a pretty area here. It rained last night, rained this morning. It stopped now. So maybe we'll go hiking. We're going to go visit the aquarium a little bit later. And then we're going to head up to Bristol. So there's our car. Getting ready to head out. Here's the hotel where we stayed. We're on the 7th floor, looking this way. Spot our room. Looks like it's clearing up. It's gonna be a nice day after all. It's already about 68, I guess. This is a nice hotel. Up here on the very top of a mountain. Gatlinburg is right over that drop off there. There's, wave to us, guys. There they are. Here we are, we're going way up to the top. Pretty high right now.
Dad, what happens if you drop that?
Oh, I don't want to do that. We're pretty high. Oh. It's a great view. Chairlift stop for a minute. Way down there is Gatlinburg.
Dad.
Just a second, honey.
My weight squashed.
There they are. Oh, Rachel's down there. Trying her best to. see the how high we are. There's another view of Gatlinburg.
Daddy,
it's a very busy town, looking like a beach town.
Dad, can you give me a cuddle?
No, honey. And our hotel was right behind that hill there. There's a little sky tower down there.
Right behind what hill?
Huh?
What hotel?
Nathan, don't bump me, honey.
Can you see the hotel?
No, not from here. It's on the other side of the hill. Ooh, what a shot.
Rachel. Move.
This is scary.
This is scary going down.
Yes, it is.
What? What?
They're taking our picture. Down there. Whoosh. Down there. All kinds of stuff here. Water slides, and they got toboggans that go on concrete pathways. Here's some bears. Oops, sorry. We're riding the tramway on down. Wait till you hear the crowd on here.
Yeah.
The biggest tramway on the East Coast, they say. Oh no, in the United States. And it's a big drop off. Oh, we're swinging.
Oh,
it feels like we're dropping. Come on back down to Gatlinburg. There's our hotel where we stayed last night. Way over there. It's a hotel. That's right, the round one on top of the mountain. That's where we stayed.
I think it's over there. We stopped over there.
Going down there. Just went over another one. Oh, we're swinging again. Still haven't passed the other cable car yet. The middle cable pulls us and it runs on the two other cables. Here comes the other cable car.
That's the way it was. It was about like that.
Towards us. Big. That's a good buy. Here's another picture of our hotel in the town. Looking right into the center of Gatlinburg. We are inside the Gatlinburg Tripoli's Aquarium now. This is the shark tank. It's a very neat setup they have here. Right under the water here is actually, you can see the people. That's the moving walkway under the water with lots of sharks swimming above them. And they have also touching centers, all kinds of interactive stuff. Over there you can climb into the little tanks, put your heads up in the middle, and look through the water from the inside. There's a big catfish. This is the edge of the Amazon, the waterfall coming down. Oh.
Where it meets their tail now, you'll see all these orange bands. There's one right here. You'll see all these orange bands, a couple of bumps, and what those are, extra scales that they use for protection. They can flip these scales out almost like a switchblade. You can use it against predators or someone else they don't want in their territory.
See everybody sitting around.
This extra scale is considered to be just as sharp as the scalpel of a surgeon, which is where they get their name. Some of our schooling fish that we have in here are black and white banner fish, which are right here. The vertical black and white stripes, yellow tail, and a long dorsal fin. Golden butterfly, which there's a couple here. Solid golden color, except for around our eye, they have a little gray patch. And our fox face rabbit fish, which there's a couple down here. They have yellow bodies, two right there. They have yellow bodies and black and white that starts above their head and goes to the end of their mouth. A couple more right there. Now these animals all school also for protection. They'll put the younger, smaller, and sometimes injured fish on the inside of the school and the healthier, larger fish on the outside. They then form as tight a group as possible and try and move in unison throughout the ocean. They do this in the fooling of predators, making the predator think once with the black and white. Starts above their head, goes to the end of their mouth. Some of them have a false eye, which is that extra set of black dots at the end of their body. This is also to fool predators. Predator will come after the fox-faced rabbit fish from the opposite direction of the head, trying to go after those two black dots, thinking it's their eyes. Fox-faced rabbit fish will head off in the opposite direction, completely confusing that predator. One of our smallest fish species that we have in the aquarium are the damselfish. Over in that large coral formation, looks like a bunch of french fries stuck together. That is staghorn coral. You will see a couple of small black and white damselfish. They're about the size of a quarter and have vertical black and white stripes. Now, although they're cute and innocent, don't let them fool you. Pound for pound, they're the most aggressive fish in this aquarium. From time to time, if Troy does not move quick enough through the tank, you will actually see them try to chase him away. One of the rules that we are given is do not touch any of the fish when you get into this aquarium. There's nothing better than watching 190 pounds of Troy being chased down by a fish the size of a quarter. We have plenty of film of it. Now, one of the most noticeable fish, there's two of them actually right here by me, look like potato with fins. Those are puffer fish. Puffer fish get their name from the ability to inhale water or air and puff up 3 to 4 times their actual size. They also do this in the hopes of fooling a predator and thinking they're much larger than they actually are. Sometimes, though, the puffer fish does not puff up quick enough. It's swallowed by the predator, who then spits him out in complete confusion on why his food just expanded in his mouth. What you'll notice sometimes about the puffer fish, and actually the golden puffer, this large green one over here by me is green brain coral. They have actually found green brain coral off the coast of Australia, roughly the size of a Volkswagen bug. The old bug, not the new bug. The reason that is a rather important fact is because coral only grows 1 inch a year. To make a coral formation the size of this green brain coral over here would take roughly 1,000 years. To make one the size of a Volkswagen bug would take a little bit over 10,000 years. To make this entire coral formation would take 100,000 years. Coral grows very slow. What coral is actually made of, even though it looks all big and magnificent over here, it's actually made of millions of small coral polyps. And what a coral polyp is a small gelatinous body form. Looks very similar to an upside down jellyfish. What this coral polyp will do is take minerals out of the salt water and form a cone around itself. And his neighbor will do the same thing.
Honey, my hippo can only hurt when the tail hits her, but it can't come up. two hands, Andrew. There you go, Andrew.
Don't hold him all the way out of the water, honey. He's just tailing there. Can it pinch you? Honey?
Huh?
Can it pinch you?
No, I don't think so. Maybe a little bit. We'll find out. There's Andrew. Deep sea diver, Andrew. There's Nathan. There. Here he is, deep sea diver Nathan.
They're a little more aggressive than the bonnet, but still pretty decent to dive with. Now we actually have two other types of shark in the tank. You don't usually see them, and they hide in crevices in the rocks. You can just barely see one down there in the back on the bottom. It's a white spotted bamboo shark and an Arabian shark. But like I said, they make their home in the rocks, whereas most of the animals we have in the tank, they've birthed the live young. We've had quite a few baby rays born already. White spotted bamboo shark lay eggs. They hide those in the rocks so they keep them protected. Now, the rays we have, like this big girl here, all over Andrew, it's called southern rays. They get about 6 to 8 feet in diameter and up to 300 pounds. She's the biggest one in the tank, and she's just about 125 pounds. So you can imagine how glad Andrew is a chance to pull her up. Now, the other rays we have kind of have the flat faces, look like birds flying around. They're called cow-nose rays. They come from Atlantic waters. They migrate down from Cape Cod to Brazil. They travel in real large schools and take an aerial photograph of schools up to 1 million of them at a time. Now, the newest addition to the tank are these guys with the spots on, called spotted eagle rays. They come from just about any tropical waters. They get real big, up to 12 feet wingtip to wingtip. And whereas most rays just have one barb, these guys have three. Now, I know it looks like they're trying to eat Andrew in there. They're not. Rays don't really have teeth. They don't really bite you. They have what's called grinding plates. And they go down and suck up shells, grind them up, suck the meat out, and spit the shell back out. So they don't really bite you, but when you dive with them, they kind of suck you and they pinkies all over you. Andrew can explain that when he gets home. They notice, too, they have these holes behind their eyes. These are called spiracles. What they do is suck water down to those spiracles and it exits on the stomach on the bottom, and that's how they breathe. Anybody take a guess why we just have rays and sharks in the tank? Do they bite off his hair? They can kind of bite you sometimes in there. I don't know if they pull any of his hair out. You can ask him when he comes up.
What are you doing, ladies?
They take them out, spray bottles, just put them in the back of special tanks so they get a little bigger.
There's a grouper. They're all in it's a moving sidewalk. Oh, true fish? Silly me. It's a moving sidewalk, although it turned off for a second. Look at the eels in the box.
Giant grouper.
Look at the eels in the box, Kelly. There's a big old shark.
Filming. Where's the camera? I'll take
that. How come I'm not moving?
Come on,
baby. Hey, Nathan.
We're going to lose you. Bye-bye.
fish, that's right. And here's two of his buddies swimming over mommy.
Wow.
Coming back. One goes out. Oh, he's going back our way. Let Rachel come up. There's Rachel. There's Andrew and Nathan. Don't fall in, Nathan. I'm trying to feel the rays. Hey, Rachel, get down. Oh, is he going to get it? Oh, almost. Almost. Neat little tank there. The rays just swim out of the deep part. Right over here. Just a whole bunch of rays and big old sharks down there. But the little ones come up.
Now just remember, don't try to touch the little shark.
Yeah.
Press up on that head shark.
They don't want you to
they
touch the little shark.
They just don't like to be pet.
Rachel freaks out.
Now you can pet any of the rays. You've taken all their stingers out. So they're perfect.
Oh, did they get it? Trying their best to catch those rays when they come by. Here comes mommy. Get it, Kelly, get it!
But just remember, don't try to pet the shark, please. Those are bonnet head sharks, and they won't hurt you. They just don't like to be touched.
And climb all the way in there to touch that thing. Did you get it? Kelly, did you get it? The whole family. They're all getting ready to take a bath, I'm sure. No one's fallen in yet. It's only a matter of time. There he comes again. Everybody down, 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 down. They're the kids.
Mm-hmm.
All right, go on, Kelly.
Mm-hmm.
I should have got the pink one.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, man. It looks like there's going to be some tummy aches here today.
Look at all that candy.
Look how much
Daddy,
candy there is.
Daddy.
Ooh, a chocolate bunny? Look at all that candy.
Daddy.
Oh, man. And
Peeps.
Ooh, Peeps. My favorite thing. I'm going to blow
them
up.
Oh, yeah. Peeps.
Piles and piles of candy. Mm-mm.
Can I
sure. It's a bunny eat? Rabbit. From Grandma and Grandpa.
You don't want more chocolate eggs?
Yes. It's a bunny rabbit Easter basket.
In the kitchen.
I'm an Easter egg hunt. Everybody's hunting.
Rachel.
It's a beautiful morning, Easter morning. Rachel's just walking around in her pajamas. There's two kids.
cruising the yard. Grandma's helping the kids find them. Looking at
them. No, I don't think you put it in the trash. I don't think it'd be any in the trash can. I don't know how many were there hidden.
Once upon a time, there was a land that was full of signs. The businesses were full of signs. Of course, the schools were full of signs. And even the homes were full of signs.
Hey, Mom.
What, sweetie?
May I go over to Jimmy's house? He found a frog.
What are you going to do with the frog?
Well, we're going to weigh it, measure it, and do a quick sketch of it. And then record all of that data in our amphibian book that we have been keeping.
That sounds like fun. Make sure you record your data accurately, and please be home in time for dinner. Yes, this world was a wonderful place. Science had given these people a home, no wars, no poverty, and very little illness.
Metamorphic rocks are formed from igneous and sedimentary rocks that have been changed in some way.
Minerals are chemical compounds that form crystals.
Interesting, very interesting. Malachi, what can you tell us about your rocks?
Rocks are an essential part of our planet. Quartz, a common mineral in granite, is light, colored, and hard. There are three groups of rocks, no matter how they're made. Igneous, metamorphic, sedimentary.
Quite sufficient, Malachi. I believe I speak for the entire class when I say that we are well aware that you are thoroughly prepared for this presentation.
Now, Liam, let's see what you have. Liam, that is an interesting way you grouped your rocks. Can you explain to us what you did?
I made a smiley face.
A smiley face? And what are you telling us about your rocks with a smiley face?
Well, nothing really. I just thought it would look nice.
It would look nice?
Yeah, the rocks are kind of boring, and I thought this would help them make them more interesting.
Rocks? Boring? What are you talking about, Liam? How could rocks ever be boring?
Thank you.
Have you come to a conclusion as Wesleyan's difficulties?
Yes. Please inform us of your findings.
Well, after a great deal of observation...
And a great deal of observation...
And a great deal of research... We have discovered something that has not been seen in years.
We believe that Leon suffers from what was known as...
A personality!
We are going to have to examine our notes and find out what we did wrong.
Yes, we will have to readjust Leon's thought patterns in order to battle this problem.
I believe that is our only course of action. I just wish things were different.
I know. Things were not like this when we were kids.
Should be such a big deal about how I do everything, not hurting anybody, just minding my own business.
Leon was definitely troubled by what was going on. After all, he was just being himself. He really wasn't bothering anybody. To help him think about this a little better, Leon took a walk in the woods. Leon walked for such a long time that he did not realize that day had become night. He was in a part of the forest that he had never been before.
She gives me the jitters.
Leon and Canine continued to walk through the forest when suddenly a very strange vision appeared to them.
Canine, what's wrong with you? Stop holding on so tight. Who are you?
Oh, you can just call me Al.
Al?
Yeah, Al. Is there something wrong with it? Plain, it's simple, it's easy to spell, and I wouldn't say anything if I were you. Leon's not the most spectacular name in the world, you know.
Sorry, I didn't mean to insult you, it's just I never met anybody like you before.
I know, I'm sorry too. It's just when I travel without my body, I become a little fussy and a little confused. It takes me a few minutes to get myself together.
Well, Al, I'm really glad to meet you. If you don't mind and you feel you can talk to me now. Who are you?
I told you already. Al.
No, I mean, what are you and what do you want with me?
Oh. Guess that would be a good place to start. Well, I'm Al.
I know that already.
And I'm here to help you with your problem.
What problem?
Oh, so there's no problem? What was all that people making a fuss and ain't nobody's business?
How did you know about that?
don't worry about it. I know it's a good thing that I do know.
Why?
Oh, I know exactly what you're going through. I've been there myself before. I know how it feels like you don't fit in and you don't belong.
You do?
Yes, and look, Boob Love, the answer to your problem is so simple and easy.
Well,
all you have to do is be yourself.
But that's what got me into the trouble in the first place.
No, other people may have trouble with your differences, but your differences are what make you, you. So if other people don't understand, they don't have to. You enjoy your individuality. Look at me. I go around without my body most of the time, and I usually have a blast.
But it's just so hard to do that.
Now look, kid, I never said it was going to be easy.
I don't know.
Leon, all you have to do is keep your chin up and keep hoping for the best.
Get up.
If you don't earn it with your hard work.
That's all we want to find out, bud.
Just be yourself and everything will be fine.
Now wait, where are you going?
Try not to worry, everything will be fine. Oh, and make sure your dog is okay.
Canine, did you see that? Come on, Canine, you don't look so good. Let me get you home.
Leon did not realize how late it had gotten. Before long, the moon began to set. When Leon's family realized that he had not come home that evening, they called the whole town together to try to find him.
Oh, where could he be?
I'm so worried.
We've looked everywhere. He's just nowhere to be found.
Now don't worry, with our combined efforts, I'm sure we can find the solution to this problem.
Where have you been? We've been so worried about you.
Yes, we're still concerned they weren't able to finish our data entry forms for the botanical project. Where were you, Leon, and why did you stay out all night?
I'm sorry, scared of you, but I met this head aunt.
A what? What are you talking about, Leon?
Well, I met this head named Dale, and...
You spent the entire night with a strange head?
Yes, but...
This is Heidi, regular.
We were afraid something like this would happen.
We're going to have to do extensive research to find out what his motivation for this behavior could be.
We'll have to begin collecting our data immediately.
Wait a minute, just wait a minute. I don't need to be studied, analyzed, or investigated. I just need all of you to listen to me.
You're listening, Leon.
I'm sorry, scared all of you, but I just need you to know something. I'm not like all of you. I don't see things the way the rest of you see them. I know that you might not understand, but that is just the way that it is. I don't like the same things that everybody else likes, and I don't like to do the same things that everybody else likes to do. I don't need to be studied, analyzed, or investigated. I just need all of you to listen to accept me for what I am.
You know, I didn't really like this lap one. I wanted to wear something more colorful.
Yeah, I've always wanted to use a different color pen besides black to collect my data.
And you know, I don't even want these glasses. I don't even need these glasses.
From that moment on, things started to change. People started to
see their individual personalities. The more individuals they started to let their true personalities shine through.
Nathan, getting ready to go down the slip and slide.
Yeah, Nathan!
Oh, that wasn't a very good one.
Oh.
Here's Rachel.
You win.
Need to be quiet.
Mom.
Woo!
My hip really hurts.
Hey,
hey, hey. My hip really hurts, Mom.
Here's our neighbor, Tony. Oh.
Rachel!
Here's Rachel with a toad. He squeaks. Don't squeeze him so hard, honey.
I saw a duck.
Show me your toad. No, no, hold him out. Hold him still.
Mom, I saw a toad.
Shh, shh. Let's hear him squeak. Have you ever heard a frog squeak?
No. His legs are sticking out.
There's Nathan, and here comes Andrew.
His legs are sticking out. His legs
I know.
Are sticking out.
Rachel, why don't you put him on the ground?
Put him on the ground.
See if he can hop.
He can hop. No! Oop,
there he goes.
No, I'll get him. No, okay. I'll get him.
This is a field presentation for my dad's birthday. Steve, hands.
Okay, now I gotta say something.
One of the actors will be Andrew Huntsman, a lamb and Philo, and the guy painting a door, which will come up. My second actor, Rachel important poet, Moses. And people painting the doors, like me. And a person collecting food. Now we will start a presentation.
Thank you. Cake mommy made.
A smiley face.
Who sang the loudest?
Mm-hmm. Me.
Mm-hmm. I sing the loudest.
Who sang the loudest?
Oh, I think Shotten sang the loudest.
She didn't sing. Who did?
Whose piece is that?
This is gonna be my piece.
Who sang the loudest, Dad?
Daddy, can I have this piece? Like,
I think Andrew sang the loudest.
No, Andrew is the quietest, I think, in the cake.
I don't know if I'd say that, Andrew.
What kind of cake is it?
I think I sang
chocolate.
I could hear myself, but I couldn't. We should get out of the biggest pieces because I hit Andrew than me. Andrew than me.
What's mine? Here's his coming, Rachel. You want the biggest?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Is that too big, Rachel?
No.
Oh, okay. Here. Remember, in your mouth, not on the floor.
I like these little peanut things.
How is it, Nathan?
Good.
How is it, Andrew?
Excellent.
Oh, I like that. How is it, Rachel?
Good.
There's Daddy. How is it, Daddy? Show
yummy.
Her. How old is Daddy?
37.
Yep. Is that young or old?
Young.
Young. Wow. Thank you.
What do you think, Nathan?
Old.
What do you think, Rachel?
Young. Old.
Daddy's old.
Yeah.
Yeah. Andrew, the light is glaring off your blonde head. What, Daddy? Turn the tape off?
There's Floyd and Linda. They're just coming back in from sailing. It was really windy earlier. Look, they're just kind of relaxing. They're laying back. Here they come. It's been a really great sailing day. It's just calming down a little bit now. Wind's still blowing nice though. A few little waves. Enjoy this beautiful weekend here at Duck.
Oh yeah. Point Daddy's finger.
That's not Daddy's finger, Mom. That's Daddy's stick. That's not Daddy's finger. That's Daddy's stick.
Yeah, that's Dad's finger.
Nice one, Dad. Whoa, Nelly. What'd you do?
He's mad.
Do
it again.
He didn't like that.
Come on, make him jump.
He knows that's his. It's a vulnerable spot. And so he doesn't want anybody poking his bottom.
Well, don't make him turn around. Let him go back in the river.
All
right. Wait, make him a noise. Hold on.
Go back!
Shh, guys. There, I heard that. Make him do it again. Yowie.
You put a dent in it.
Here, I got his mouth. Let him bite the stick one more time. Look at his little nosy. Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom presents Steve Heinzman, turtle hunter.
Oh, you grabbed that one pretty hard.
Okay, Mr. Turtle.
All right, let me take a still picture.
Go bye-bye. We don't want you here at our house. You might eat our toes. See that? That's the river. You need to go in there. Here's the kids. Daddy's teaching them how to be turtle hunters. Okay, Nathan, give him your toe. He would love that.
He wants a little snacky.
He hasn't had any breakfast.
He would love your toe. Just think, if he can swallow a big old...
Hi, Rachel.
...turkey neck, he could fit your whole hand in his mouth. All right, Nathan, that's close enough, buddy. All right, let me drag him to the water.
Mother Nature. Okay, here comes Big Fearless Daddy.
All right.
Don't be mean to the turtle.
I'm not being mean, I just wanted to
see. I'm talking to the boys.
Hear him hissing? All right, that's enough rocks in the yard. All right, watch out, I'm going to go drag him to the shore now.
Come back over by the house.
Whoa-wee.
Cool.
Woo! Rich, why don't you walk over here?
I think Daddy's a little nervous.
So am I.
The turtle's got Daddy on the run. Who's going to win? Ding, ding, round one. I give the points to the turtle.
Wow, he's got a strong jaw, too.
Daddy is armed with a hoe and a net. The turtle, jaws of steel. Who's going to win this?
The human.
He doesn't want to turn his back to us. He doesn't want to do it.
Trying to get Mr. Turtle to go in the water.
Because he bit the net. I think Turtle got one.
Here he goes. Ooh, he says, look, water.
Ooh, Daddy.
There
Daddy.
He goes, off into the wild.
Up. Oh,
he's looking back. Bye, guys. I had a good time.
Now I want to eat one of your tins.
Happy 4th of July. Please leave me alone. You gave me a headache. Come here, little girl in yellow. You look yummy.
Let's go.
I think that if we go up to the house, he'll get in the water.
Yeah. Right, let's back up. He has to defend himself with his jaws.
So. Okay, everybody say bye-bye to the turtle.
Bye, turtle.
Bye-bye, you nutso dude.
We can always delete it, that's a beauty.
Are you all done?
What?
They have these,
Well, I was taking still pictures, but I filled everything up. Look, there's Andrew. He is driving it a little bit. Zooming around. Here we are, here's the last of the three coming in. Grandma.
Here comes Nathan! Woo! Rachel! Keep going! Keep going! Woo! Look at her ride! There goes Rachel! She just learned to ride a bike! And here comes Nathan! Maybe not.
I stopped because you were in the way. No, standing right in the middle of the trail.
Keep going! Go, Nathan.
I just run off with all these things.
I know. Keep going.
Go.
There they go, the Heinzman children. Don't run over your sister. Boink.
Let's go for a walk.
Yeah. What?
Hey,
let's go for a walk.
Here he comes. Rachel, turn around and come back. I think Nathan wiped out and he doesn't have on his pads. There went Nathan again.
I shot me. Yeah, your mommy was looking for these.
Save a little bit of that.
There's like no time.
Go, it's pool games. At the pool.
Go, go, go.
Oh, go, go.
There's Andrew and Nathan. Did they get Nathan got some? Andrew got some. Now they're gonna count them all up. Looking for the money now that they just threw in the pool.
Come on, just see Nathan. Oh.
Yeah. Andrew's diving, he's got some. He's looking around. Oh, they're fighting for it. There's Nathan. Oh, Nathan's got the mother load over here though, right by the steps. Here we go. We're gonna get a greased watermelon. Oh, that's a little too easy. It's hard with a life jacket on. Can you get in the deeper part, honey?
Over there, Megan. Hold it in, pick it up and pick it up. Oh. Megan,
right there. Come on, Megan,
right there.
Right there. Right there.
Ooh, don't
foot.
Skin your knees, though. There you go. Keep looking, Rachel.
Thank you.
dance with a girl. Because it's fun. Let me see you shake your groove thing. I don't know. You don't have one? Rachel, baby, that is shaking your groove thing. Nikki, do you have a groove thing? Is that yummy, Katie? What are you eating?
Brownie.
I can't hear you.
Brownie. That's just too cute.
Natty, can you say no, 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 no? No, 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 no. I'm a good girl. Go walk to Miss Katie.
Here's Janet and Katie and Rachel. They're feeding the geese. Katie. Rachel.